But I'm doing weirder shit. I don't know why, I'm turning into a weirder alcoholic, talking to my coffee down the back of the coffee shop just to weird people out wearing slippers into places I shouldn't be wearing slippers. I don't even own a pair of fucking slippers. For some reason I found myself watching a homeless couple kissing this morning. I mean that. I didn't just see him. I watched him. It's lovely watching these crusty lovers. Enjoying the moment, clattering the gums off each other. It's lovely. Some of you are wondering, is this true? Are we at a lecture? No, it did, because it kind of reminded me of a day, it's a mix of emotions, like a day out in the zoo. Do you know that kind of way? When you see your monkey play with his knob for the first time. You might be a little disgusted at first, but quickly you're thinking, you're a fucking fair play to you. I know what it is. I know what the weirdness is. I'm turning into my outlet. Has anybody else seen that turn? You fucking have seen that turn. It's like a vampire bit you 3 days ago and you forgot. Why are my teeth getting bigger? What's that about? Jesus. And that's the thing. You've no choice. You're going to turn into whoever raised you. You've no choice. You weren't raised by wolves down the river. You're not that cool. Trust me. You're going to turn into whoever raised you. I got to see a snapshot a couple of months ago. I got to see a snapshot of what I'm about to turn into. I was heading down the country to do a gig. Rang ahead to see where the parents in. The old man answered the phone like this. Ah! You've a fair idea what you're dealing with there, don't you? Like, this fellow could have been around 4,000 years ago and his day wouldn't have changed the whole body. Do you know what I mean? Like, pure fucking savagery coming out of his nose and ears. Like, all day fucking long. It's what you want. I said, I'm just ringing ahead to see where you're in. I don't have to pee. And I swear to God, his answer to that was, how the fuck would I answer the phone if I wasn't here? Like, he's not even trying to be a dickhead. That's the way his brain thinks. What you want, Tanera? I said, just see what you're doing. What are you doing?
Gardening.
Now that man has never gardened a day in his life. Any man that sounds like that doesn't know what gardening is. So I'm intrigued to see what this mad bastard is at, right? Intrigued. So I get into the yard about a half an hour later. Now this is proper countryside, like just no, there's no neighbor with, hey, there's none of that shit goes on. Like you'd have to fucking ring them if you want to talk to the neighbors, that kind of way. But I get out of the car and from the back of the house I hear the unmistakable sound of a shotgun going off, right? Again, that's not weird where I'm from, that could be dinner. Do you know what I mean? That's not. But I mean, he did say he was gardening, so let's see what he's on about, right? I head around the side of the house and the first thing I see, I swear to God, is a busted chainsaw thrown on the ground, right? Right, and it's clearly been hopped in temper off the ground too. I get a little further, I see a half-cut oak tree. Now, I'm not suggesting everybody in this room owns a chainsaw, or has ever handled a chainsaw, but if you were, and your chainsaw stopped halfway through an oak tree, you'd go and get another fucking chainsaw. Not my alpha. He saw this as a perfect opportunity to go inside and beat this tree properly. He went to the gun safe, brought out a double barrel shotgun and 2 boxes of shells, and stood this close to the half cut old tree. Fucking tree, I'll show you the tree. Hey Tom, how are you? Gardening. I watched him put 36 shots into that fucking tree. Like, at shot 3 or 4, you think, this mightn't be right. No fucking way. I mean, he got the tree down at the end. Mother of divine Jesus. Like, I'm only 30 years away from that shit. And I already look like I'm going to hunt one of you down on the way home. Like, what? I'm going to look like in my 30s, just naked, shouting at airplanes, because I forgot how to speak English. I haven't a hope.